important to get your booster when it's ready, and it's really important not just for you but Australia, because what we're seeing overseas is if we don't keep the booster program up, we're going to have increasing outbreaks as the year goes on, coming into winter next year. It's just good to have as many vaccines as we can have as booster doses. So at the moment, Pfizer is the only one that's been approved by both the TGA and ATAGI at this moment. Interestingly, the AstraZeneca vaccine can also be given for those people that have an allergy to the mRNA vaccine. The long history of being able to mix vaccines for the same condition, and in fact possibly getting more bang for your buck in doing so. And just over the last day or so, we're seeing much stronger data, for example, that Moderna as a second shot after a Pfizer shot, AstraZeneca, is also potentially more effective than having two of the same shots. Given the TGA approval, it is likely that ATAGI will approve the use of Moderna on top of any of the two previous shots.
Scientific literature is saying that it is safe to mix vaccines. The literature that's just come out in the last week shows that actually, in some cases, if you receive a first dose of AstraZeneca and Pfizer and then you get a Moderna, your response is a lot larger.
The Pfizer vaccine is really good at producing quite a strong antibody response, but the AstraZeneca vaccine is a little bit like the tortoise and the hare. It's quite good at producing a T cell response, the other half of the immune system. And that combination, it's almost like a 1+1=3 effect in terms of potentially getting a little bonus because you've mixed the vaccines. We know is after your first two doses, what happens is there is a slow reduction in immunity over time. Your vaccines are still really good at stopping you getting serious disease and dying, but the immunity drops, so it's somewhat more likely you catch COVID, possibly more likely to transmit it. The government really needs to look at what happened in Europe and not to fall into the trap of complacency that we've just done the job, because we may not have.